The last century, the 20th century, was a cataclysmic century for the world. Two world wars, the development of nuclear weapons. But two things came out of this century which define this century that we're in. The first is that democracy won out over totalitarianism, whether it's fascism or whether it was totalitarian communism. By the end of the 20th century and going into our century, most Western cultures were democratic. The second is that free markets won out over collectivism as the way to create prosperity, especially in democracies. Now, financial markets play a unique role in the issue of free markets. And America stands as the beacon on the issue of democracy and free markets. And as we go forward, it is critical that we, as financial markets, understand our role in this process. Robert Shiller, the Nobel Prize-winning economist from Yale, recently said in his book on the good societies, finance and the good societies, the essential challenge for the leaders to contemplate in coming to terms with the future of finance is to understand that it can be used to help broaden prosperity across an increasingly wide range of social classes. Imagine the development of a new laboratory, the funding of a medical research center, the building of a new university, the construction of a new city subway system. Finance provides the structure for these, to these and other enterprises and institutions throughout society. If finance succeeds for all of us, it helps build a good society. But we're not assured that it will succeed. In fact, over 200 years ago, Adam Smith, who was really the founder of the concept of free markets, made this point. He said, "The great nations are never impoverished by private, though they are sometimes by public prodigality and misconduct." Put it another way, people don't undermine great nations. Governments acting badly undermine great nations. Or as Milton Friedman said, "If you put the federal government in charge of the Sahara Desert in 5 years, they'd be a shortage of sand." The forces that can never negatively impact the market in an economy, and a free market economy, are considerable. But let me note three that I think we have to be concerned about today. The first is our federal debt and our deficits. We have doubled our federal debt in the last 8 years. We will triple it by the year 2022. Our deficits continue to expand and are projected to expand for as far as the eye can see. We have seen other nations which have gone down this path of excessive debt and debt, and we know that inevitably it leads to an economic event that is a dislocation event, where the currency comes under attack and the standard of living of the people of those nations are reduced. So we have to hope that our federal government can get its act together, and hopefully over the next few months they can take a major step in that direction. And we as a financial industry should be of assistance and certainly be promoting responsible fiscal policy at the federal level. The second issue is this piling on of regulations. Appropriate regulations are necessary, but excessive regulations can chill economic expansion and undermine entrepreneurship. We are seeing a new regulation now about every 2.8 days. We've had enough regulations to fill up 28 volumes of War and Peace. 15 million words have been issued under Dodd-Frank, and we're only 39% of the way through. So we got another 20 million words to go. Believe me, this will have an impact on our economic prosperity if we do not step up and try to get responsible regulations. We as a financial market industry are totally committed to working with regulators for responsible regulations. But we also have to say, at a point, the pendulum has swung too far. The third issue is what I call galloping populism. Ads Core is